The judge Abadu Isifo made the comments at the Nalerugo District Court where he was sitting in for the substantive judge who is currently on leave. The case before him was between two plaintiffs, a businessman and a civil servant, who have filed a separate suit against the Tissin Toba Community Bank Limited after allegedly persistent failure to assess their monies. One of the plaintiff's claims read in court said he deposited a cash sum of 5,225.84 cedis, being part payment of his March 2020 salary, which he deposited with the bank but of which he has since not been paid despite persistent demands. Among the relief sought, this plaintiff asked for full payment of his deposit, payment of accrued interest and costs to be awarded against the bank and any other or others that the court might deem fit. After the claims of the plaintiffs were respectfully read, the judge asked the defendant represented by the chief clerk if he had wanted to say something in defense. The chief clerk pleaded liable but with an explanation. He said, quote, "My lord, all that he said is true. Indeed, he is one of our cherished customers, but we are facing insolvency and liquidity crisis," unquote. He, however, pleaded for more time to settle the matter. The judge, before passing his judgment, took on the Bank of Ghana, blaming it for the current mess in the banking sector and calling it the most irresponsible institution in the country. He cited his experience with the now-defunct Ejiramai Rural Bank and how he had had to make decisions to sell off the bank assets and properties to pay its depositors. The judge said the failure of the central bank to regulate the operations of rural banks has created doubt in the financial sector, which according to him is a recipe for trouble in the country. In his judgment, Amadu Isifu entered a plea of liability and ordered the defendant to pay in 3 months after granting all the relief sought for by both plaintiffs. The judge warned the defendant that failure to comply with his judgment, the plaintiff had the duty to file a motion ex parte to go into execution. One of the plaintiffs in an interview after the ruling thanked the judge and said he was ready to enforce the court orders if the bank failed to comply.
"I am extremely excited by the ruling. I have been doing business with the bank, but as you can see clearly in court, they did not know what to say when the judge asked them about my money. I am a businessman working hard to take care of my family, but my store is currently empty, so I'm happy by the ruling. I have heard the bank owed other people." "I hereby advise them to also take legal action against the bank to get their monies released because their action has affected my business negatively."
Hundreds of clients of the bank have appealed to government to help them retrieve their monies locked up in the bank since 2017. Some of the clients include the East Mampusi Municipal Assembly, which has not been able to release monies meant for persons with disability for 3 years now, leaving the beneficiaries to rely on alms to survive. Elias Sutanko reporting.